welcome to Bobcat Updates. I'm April Bennett.
And I'm Crystal Kilgore.
Local troops are on their way to Iraq after leaving San Marcos on Monday. Jared Apperson has the story.
Friends and family gathered at the Army Reserve 13th Support Command to say their tearful goodbyes to local reservists heading for Iraq. San Marcos Mayor Robert Habengreiter gave a heartfelt speech that expressed the San Marcos community's support.
As mayor of the city of San Marcos, Texas, do hereby proclaim the first day of December 2003 as San Marcos Army Reserve Day.
The troops were escorted out of San Marcos by local police and arrived in Fort Hood Monday afternoon. Once in Iraq, the troops will be aiding in water purification, logistics planning, transportation, and ammunition.
Friends and family members all showed up today to salute our soldiers and wish them well on their long journey.
The troops are scheduled to come home sometime in summer 2004.
For Bobcat Update, I'm Jared Apperson.
The president of the Iraqi Governing Council says that Iraqis are considering the creation of new military units, possibly to include local militias. This will help U.S.-led coalition troops battle insurgents. Council President says announcements soon will be made about efforts to boost security. U.S. officials say participants for any Iraqi force should be independent individuals chosen for their skills and strictly loyal to the new Iraqi force.
President Bush is working to protect the nation's forests. The president signed the largest forest treatment legislation of the past 25 years today. The new law makes it easier to cut excess trees from overgrown forests. These trees can provide fuel for wildfires like the ones that have recently devastated California. The law is supposed to protect forests, but environmentalists fear it will have the opposite effect. The Prime Outlet Mall makes Christmas shopping a little less stressful and a lot more fun. Sadie Marina tells us how with this Bobcat update.
Christmas is just around the corner and holiday shoppers are out buying gifts. The Prime Outlet Mall expects their sales to increase from 5 to 7% in the next few weeks. The outlet mall has planned for the extra shoppers. There will be police officers in the parking lot directing visitors where to park, and a tram will be provided to pick up people who had to park far away. Prime Outlet employees are working to great lengths to accommodate their shoppers. Gallagher tells us how one manager takes customer service to the extreme.
One gal got a call from one of her customers that flies in, and she comes in to the bus station, and the store manager actually goes and picks her up to bring her in so she can shop. I mean, our store go above and beyond to make the sale.
Shoppers come from all over the world during this season to catch the discounts and enjoy the Christmas carolers traveling throughout the mall.
I also have people that come from Germany, Canada, the outlying states like Louisiana, Oklahoma, and further parts of Texas always, and lots of people from Mexico.
Stores are extending their hours, and some are giving free gifts to the shoppers who spend at least $250. Shoppers are advised to get here early and beat the traffic. For Bobcat Update, I'm Sadie Marino.
Texas State University police are putting together a day with San Marcos kids. Christina Slaughter has more.
The second annual Shop with a Cop is coming up, and the children of San Marcos are busy drawing for the event. Shop with a Cop is a contest for elementary school students in San Marcos.
As a matter of fact, this year we made Shop with a Cop even bigger. We got more donations from Walmart as well as through our police department. I believe this year we're going to have up to 12 winners from grades kinder all the way through fourth from all four elementary schools combined.
The children draw pictures of what it would be like to shop with a cop, and they send them to the university police department. These drawings will be entered into a contest. Winners then will get $50 to $100 to spend, depending on their age.
We had the children bring in the entry. Well, actually, we had the entries picked up from the local elementaries. We brought them in here to the university police department. We had our officers judge them. Through the judging, we determined the winners, and at that time, we had each winner receive a $100 shopping spree from Walmart.
Shop with a Cop is scheduled for December 13th, and it starts at 8 a.m., so come to the Walmart off Highway 80 to support the kids.
It's the holiday season, and standing in line to check out can be a headache. Lauren Yannity has this Bobcat update.
Big crowds are filling up area stores, and some find that waiting in line can be frustrating. Walmart, though, has a solution, self-checkout.
With self-checkout, you go at your own pace. I feel that I get out and get in a lot faster.
Self-checkout is a simple process. The customer is guided by a computer-generated voice, and most find it's easier to go at their own pace instead of waiting in line.
the lines here at Walmart can be crazy, you know, like 10 people wide, and you're waiting forever. Someone might forget their, you know, the thing they need for dinner. But self-checkout, like I said, you go at your own pace. I feel it's a lot more convenient.
The new system can be cumbersome for those shoppers who pay with checks. Becky Torres says it creates a hassle, and she prefers to stick with the traditional way.
If there's something wrong, I don't have to wait for somebody to come. I can always tell them right then and there. So I think I'm just going to keep going through the register.
But Walmart provides both types of checkout systems to satisfy customers. In fact, there are still employees who stand by and help. The only concern is security. The computer is programmed to know how much each item weighs and what the customer is putting in the bag. Customers appear pleased with the system and say they're finding it a little less stressful to shop during the holidays.
Shopping is now made easier here at Walmart. All you have to do is scan and put it in the bag.
$2.97.
For this Bobcat Update, I'm Lauren Hannity.
Coming up on Bobcat Update, find out how a man was arrested 400 times and why Men Against Violence are asking students to sign pledge cards.
Studies. Would you like a little help? Then you should visit the Student Learning Assistance Center located on the fourth floor of Alkeck Library. The Slack Lab provides free academic assistance to students in subjects such as accounting, finance, science, English, history, languages, mathematics, CIS, computer science, and other subjects that have computer-aided instruction. Slack also offers development in reading textbooks, taking notes, taking tests, overcoming procrastination, managing time, and setting goals. Slack Lab can even help you find your own private tutor. So, for more information, check out Slack online or just stop by on the fourth floor of Alkeck Library. It may be the best thing you've done yet.
Police are seeking two Hispanic men for the Sunday night robbery of the La Palma grocery at 104 Tampico Street. The suspects entered the store at approximately 7:52 p.m. The first suspect grabbed the clerk on duty, while the second suspect emptied the register. One was described as heavily built, around 5'2", with dark skin, wearing a blue hooded sweater and a blue baseball cap. The second had a thin build, around 5'10", wearing a black cotton coat and blue baseball cap. Both were said to be between 30 to 35 years old. No arrests have been made. Anyone with information is urged to contact the San Marcos Police Department Criminal Investigation Division.
An Indiana man on Tuesday was arrested for his 400th time and sentenced to 17 years in prison on drunk driving charges. 74-year-old Geraldine Redmond was arrested in July while driving, even though his license had been suspended for life after scores of alcohol-related offenses. Redmond has apparently had his license suspended for life five times. Police have been arresting Redmond since 1947.
Students are being persuaded not to drink and drive during the holidays. Men Against Violence, The Network, and students with alternative transportation are challenging students to be responsible when they drink. The organizations are asking students to sign pledge cards, holding them accountable to the pledge made. The pledge cards will be mailed to the student as a reminder of their agreement. The Alcohol and Drug Resource Center is offering a big incentive for pledging. Students who pledge will be entered into a raffle to win a DVD player or gift certificates from local businesses. While driving while intoxicated can result in fines up to $4,000 or up to a year in jail.
The holidays are approaching and many people are ready to travel. With some driving safety tips is Bobcat Update's Sarah Casper.
The holidays are the busiest travel days of the year, and now's the time to get prepared. After packing and loading up the car, remember to be safe while driving. Be aware of what is around you.
Statistically, people, when they travel during the holidays, they travel in a large family, a group. The stress level goes up for the driver. Everybody needs to, you know, be quiet, keep the radios down a little bit more so you can hear people maybe slamming on their brakes, honking their horn, definitely cell phone use. If you're not using a hands-free kit, you don't need to be talking on your cell phone when you're driving your car.
Officer Glennywinkle says there are a few things to keep in mind when driving during the holidays.
Motorcycle safety. Motorcycles aren't very safe, but they are if you wear your helmet, wear your seatbelt. Seatbelts save lives. Statistics show that. Don't drink and drive during the holidays or any other time throughout the year. And just be cautious and be aware of the other drivers around you. Drive defensively.
It's important to be safe this holiday season. Any questions regarding safety or safety tips can be answered at the University Police Department. For Bobcat Update, I'm Sarah Casper.
The search continues for a 22-year-old college student from North Dakota. Drew Shadeen was last seen on November 22nd leaving the mall where she worked. Convicted sex offender Alfonso Rodriguez Jr. has been arrested in connection with the disappearance. Rodriguez has served time for the rape, and authorities says he was near the mall when the crime occurred. Officials won't say whether the suspect is cooperating, but the missing woman's family is still hopeful she'll be found alive.
Ohio police are investigating the shooting of a woman on an interstate last week. The 62-year-old woman was killed while riding in a car. Officials have linked the shooting to a mysterious spree that started near Columbus last May. Authorities now believe the same gun was used in 12 other shootings. They are questioning a man in connection with the shooting about 90 miles north of Columbus, though they say it does not appear to be connected to the other incidents at this point. When we return, find out how students relieve their stress today and some exciting news for seniors graduating in December.
Okay, mister, studied algebra in school and got a better job than I could. You take the last call.
Oh, no, mister. Stuck in an entry-level job because you only learned basic math. I don't have a boss riding my butt like you do, so you take it so you can get back to your desk.
You know, I probably should, but maybe Miss AP Calculus with the $200 haircut in the big office upstairs would like a cup.
Oh, no, mister. What was your name again? Never mind, it doesn't matter. I'm too busy doing important things to care. I just came down for some sweetened stir.
You know, if my limited math abilities weren't keeping me from getting a better job, I'd quit this afternoon.
I don't blame you. But thank goodness you're stuck here because we really need someone to make the coffee.
Light it up, baby. Come on. Come on. Light it up, baby. Come on. Light it up, baby.
County commissioners have approved a $5,000 donation to the Hays County Veterans Memorial that will go towards helping with its completion. The memorial was officially unveiled on Veterans Day, but the work continues. Veterans Memorial Chairman Richard Cruz said he's grateful to the county for its contribution and that money is still needed to complete the project. Cruz also said the donations will help with the fountain and back wall. The granite monument is engraved with the names of Hays County who died in combat during World War I, World War II, Korea, Vietnam, and Desert Storm. For more information about contributions, contact Richard Cruz at 245-2502.
The Texas State football field is now the Jim Wacker Field at Bobcat Stadium. The legendary football coach was honored during halftime at a recent Texas State game. The University Board of Regents approved the name change to honor Wacker, who passed away earlier this year from cancer. He was the football coach at Southwest Texas State from 1979 to 1982. During his tenure, the Bobcats won back-to-back national championships in their division. Graduating seniors actually have one less thing to worry about. Abby Moyer has this Bobcat update.
With the end of the semester in sight, it is an especially stressful time for students who are preparing for graduation. But many seniors will be relieved to know they are still permitted to walk the stage whether or not they pass all of their classes. Mass Communication Advisor Angel Martinez says the university simply assumes all students who have applied for graduation will make the grade.
What we will do is assume that they're actually going to pass their courses and they'll get their name put in the program and everything because all that has to be done way far in advance.
Although it shouldn't have any effect on their academic standing, seniors who fail to meet grade requirements must return in the spring to retake the failed classes. Some students say being allowed to walk the stage regardless is a relief.
Because I wouldn't want to tell my mom that I wasn't graduating. I'd like to go ahead and get on with the ceremony and then just make up that one class.
Martinez's advice for students who are planning on graduating is prepare early. They should address invitations and purchase caps and gowns before midterms so that when finals roll around, they can commit more time to studying, causing less stress and better grades. For Bobcat Update, I'm Abby Moyer.
Finals are just around the corner, and this is how some Texas State students are preparing for them.
I think going out helps so I can get rid of stress. So, you know, a couple of drinks, that's all. That's it.
Just
stay, chill out, study when I want to, play some video games. So I guess I won't go out as much yet, definitely.
I have to study a lot. I'm going to have to, because I've been kind of slacking off a little bit, so I'm going to have to buckle down.
I ain't letting no final stress me out. You know what I'm saying? I'm knocking them down, like bowling pins, you already know. I'm knocking them down.
Students looking to blow off a little steam found relief in the quad today. SAC has sponsored an inflatable boxing event in the quad in the hopes that it would help students relieve some pre-final stress. The boxing was held in a ring with two boxers giving a few minutes to fight each other wearing oversized gloves. The event was originally scheduled as part of the Cricket Fest in September, but was rescheduled due to rain. Thanks for joining us for another edition of Bobcat Update. This was the last show of the semester, but we'll be back in the spring, so be sure to tune in for the latest news. Happy holidays!